Greetings, loved ones, and welcome back to my channel. And welcome back to another reaction video. I've done a couple of these in the past. I have reacted to my first videos on this channel, you know, when I was in my Miss Meghan makeup days. My best friend Evan and I have also reacted to our old boyfriend tag together from like circa 2013. I've also done reacting to comments on my most viral video. I've done a couple of these, you know, but I've never done a reaction video to who I was before I was Miss Meghan Makeup, when I was cheerleader for life 647. First off, that username I completely stole from my older sister, Lindsay. I think her like AOL or something back in the day was dancer for life 647. And I was like, you know what? I'm just gonna steal it and be cheerleader for life 647. Like, was I okay? No. Also, a couple of disclaimers. I have incense burning behind me. So if you see some smoke wafting up, it's not anything burning on my couch or anything. I also have an extra set of eyes on this content with me. I have my emotional support squishmallow here, Fantasia, just in case I need to cringe so hard watching this content back that I need to give her a squeeze, you know? So she's just gonna be here if I need her. And I just can't wait to go back and watch these videos with you guys because I only have one public video left on this old channel. Everything else is private. I just don't want you guys to go back and be able to watch them unless we're doing it together, you know? Unless we're sharing the laughs of how cringe it is because it's just not my fave, okay? Whoa, oh my God. A wild panda has come downstairs. I thought that was rude. Also, before we get into it, I just wanted to thank the sponsor of this video, which is Surfshark VPN. I am so excited that I finally got a VPN because I have a lot of accounts, many different accounts across many different platforms. 21 of my passwords have now been compromised. And I said, oh my God, I need to do something about this. So now I finally joined Surfshark and it's been an iconic experience. Truly, I'm feeling very secure. And if you don't know what a VPN is, it is a virtual private network. Surfshark is available as an easy to use app or as a browser extension. So you could place your phone or your laptop anywhere in the world and surf the web. So basically that means you could access the internet as if you were in another country. This allows you to unlock things that are not available on Netflix or on Hulu in your country, but maybe they're available in the UK. So being able to access and unblock websites and enjoy them has been so amazing for me. But also the reason why I really, really wanted to get a VPN is because of my password security and I just wanted another level of privacy. And Surfshark gives me that extra layer of security so that my data is encrypted through them and my browsing history is hidden so no average Joe can just see all of the stuff I'm doing online. Also, as an online person, I have a lot of different devices. I have my phone, this laptop, my PC computer for streaming. I also have an old laptop that houses a lot of my old content on it. And so I can have one Surfshark account across all of my devices, which is incredible. So this all being said, you can check out Surfshark and use my code Meghan for 83% off plus 3 extra months for free. Also a huge plus is that Surfshark offers a 30-day money back guarantee if you don't like it. So there's really no risk in you trying it. If anything, there's risk in you not getting a VPN. But anyways, the link is in the description below if you guys want some more info. And without further ado, let's just get into the first video here, which is the very first music video I ever made. It was with my friend Claire. I'm gonna try to blur her face in editing just so I don't dox her. But I just wanna say, Claire, if you ever see this, thank you so much. Because without Claire, I actually don't know if I would even be interested in making YouTube videos because we used to have sleepovers. We would make these absurd dance videos and other fun things, and it was just, it gave me some nice purpose for my creative outlets, and this was actually the first video I ever edited myself. And I remember how hard it was to sync up the music to our dance moves. But some of you may actually remember the viral video that Matt and Colton made. It was just like two hot guys in high school who were much older than us. And they made this viral dance video to Yes by LMFAO. And after we saw that video, we were like, oh my God, like we have to learn the dance and recreate it. For some reason, this says that it was posted on March 5th, 2015. But this was probably filmed in like 2009 or something. I think I was in 6th or 7th grade. So that doesn't entirely make sense to me, but let's just get the heck on into it, okay? This is the cringe. That is Yes, LMFAO Dance by Cheerleader for Life 647.
Every day I see my dream. Every day I see my every day
it's
I
so
see
loud.
My dream. Every day I see my dream. Every day I see my dream. Every day I see my every day I see my dream. Every day I see my dream. Every day I see my dream. Every day I see my dream.
No. Okay, the muscle tees and the sports bras, they were a serve. I remember all of the dance moves. I just cannot believe this happened. Like, we were literally 11 or 12. And it's so off sync. We both had braces too. I don't know why we put Sharpie on our arms. Oh, because it says yes, and then we were doing it with our forearms, sure.
Waking up next to a beautiful girl, step outside and say hello to my beautiful world. Grandma's
I think we're wearing my brother's hat. I was taking this so serious. I always did. All in.
How my album's doing today. The group LMFAO goes double platinum. Hey!
I cannot believe, like, we didn't know them and we made that sign. I wonder if I still have that shirt. Oh, there's bloopers. See, I just took everything so seriously. Like, in the reaction video I filmed with Nevin, you could just see how much I had put into it, you know? Oh my god, I farted on her. I fully farted on her. Okay, this honestly, it was more pure than cringe. It just kind of is a testament to the times. She silly stringed my camera there. Oh my god. Her pool was so iconic. Miss her work. That was, wow. You know, I have some feelings about that, but more so, I think that they are pure feelings than they are like, oh my god, how cringy, you know, because I was just young, dumb, and having fun. But the next one that I want to react to is my first ever tag. And if you guys were OG YouTube watchers, you know that tag videos were so popular. And my favorite thing about this tag is the bio says, enjoy. I wasn't tagged by anyone to do this, but I did it anyways. And I just know that, okay, so this was filmed on July 2nd, 2011. So this was the year before I became Miss Meghan Makeup. This was almost exactly a year because the first day that I made a YouTube video on my Miss Meghan Makeup channel was June 30th, 2012. Anyways, in the background, you can see I was working on my iconic collage wall. Do you remember her work? It's just crazy to see it as like a little sliver, you know, compared to the full wall. I also have some Coach bags hanging up behind me, which is also a testament to the time. And I have absolutely never watched this again after I uploaded it. So if this was July 2011, I was 14. So this must have been a year or two after the Yes LMFAO dance, okay? So let us enjoy. My voice.
And if you don't know what that is,
basically I was so scared.
Insults or bad names that you've been called.
Oh no.
Into something positive. Sorry if I'm looking down. The pages are on the floor, and so I keep looking at them.
the disclaimers.
Okay, so one of the things I've been called is really a broad topic, I guess. And
my voice is literally cracking.
I've seen so many of these videos, basically all of them, this isn't it. First one is ugly. I call this because of my hair.
Oh,
my
no.
Breath, my skin. No. Acne. I used to have pretty bad acne, 6th and 7th grade.
No.
And then I went to the dermatologist.
I'm like, I saw my dermatologist, so I'm not ugly anymore, guys. I swear.
Blackheads like all over my chin and like blackheads, all that, you know, fun stuff.
I just want to give her a hug. This is so sad.
Many times before, and somebody calls me that now, and I'm just like, okay. If you're one to tell me that to my face, it's different than just like writing it anonymously on my form spring or.
On my form spring? No, 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 no. I've spent like 2 minutes on this first question, just fully being like, and if you say this to people, you're like the worst person ever. And like, what's the point? Like, when people call me that, I'm literally just like, okay. It's like, girl, just say it and let it go, you know? But this tag was kind of iconic back in the day because it was just kind of taking back the mean insults you've been called and being like, you know what, I actually don't care about this, okay? But you could just tell in this video that I was really still working through, you know, kind of, I guess, disassociating myself from those comments that I would start to get online. And especially after I started my beauty YouTube channel where I was doing like tutorials and you could see my skin and stuff, I was just gearing up truly for receiving more of those comments. And I was just talking about like having acne and I'm like, girl, I just want to give you a hug. It's okay. You're literally 14. Ugh.
Another one is bitch.
Oh my God. I literally said, I'm not a bitch, I'm just standing up for myself. Wow, the Aries jumped out here. She did. And you can see just like young, fiery Meg prepared for this firing back of an answer.
I don't know why I can't just express my opinion. I'm not like insulting people. I'm standing up for myself and what I believe in and my opinion and everything. So I don't take crap from people easily. If you're going to sit there and make fun of me, I'm going to sit there and express my opinion on what I think about that.
Honestly,
if you don't agree with my opinion, you're going to call me a bitch, but I'm just strong-willed. Another one,
iconic.
The only time that it really actually got to me was when one of my friends told me that another one of my friends called me fat.
What?
Size 2. I have curves, I have boobs, I have a butt. I'm not like afraid to say that.
When I don't remember who called me that. This is why middle school was a traumatic experience for so many people. I literally said that one of my friends called me fat. That's horrible.
Like, why would she call me that? And then the girl was like, well, we were looking at pictures from like a long time ago. And then she was just like, wow, Meghan's gotten fat. Obviously, since like 5th and 6th grade, I'm not gonna look the same by just being like, you're fat to somebody. You can change their whole outlook on themselves. They could like develop an eating disorder or, you know, start cutting themselves because they don't think they're good enough.
Oh my God,
positive word for that is healthy, because I'm not overweight, I'm not underweight. My sister also had this in her video, because obviously we both have red hair. Probably already know what I'm talking about right now, and don't laugh at me, but ginger. It started in 6th grade.
Yes, oh my God, this is literally trauma.
And guys and me, they were talking, and then one of Nagaki, he was like, hey, she's a ginger. And I didn't know what it was, so I was like, what? And he was like, you don't know what a ginger is? And I was like, no. And then he was like, go home and watch the South Park episode, Gingers Have No Souls.
Oh no.
So I just like went home and I looked it up on YouTube, and it was like, South Park, you guys obviously already know what I'm talking about.
Okay, this experience in general for me in middle school was so horrible because you obviously just like want so much attention from boys. Well, not obviously, I mean, it depends on what you're into, but I did. And this entire group of boys that I was friends with all started calling me Ginger, and it was like fucking horrible. And you could just tell in this, I'm still so uncomfortable and affected by it. And even after like this year, you know, like I said, I was 14, I still like boycotted South Park. I was like, I hate them for that. I hate them for perpetuating that, all of that. Instead of just being like, that's a stupid episode, they make fun of literally everybody. I held on to it for so long. Until I started seeing Finley, and then we started watching it together, and I was like, oh, this show is actually really funny, and they're not just making fun of gingers, they're making fun of literally everybody on the world ever. So to 14-year-old Meg, I just want to say, you're not special, girl, but I get the pain, all right?
And I honestly think this is the stupidest thing I've ever heard for somebody to be like, you have no soul. Really? Because of a South Park episode, I apparently have no soul now. All right.
I'm like on the verge of tears. I'm like, all right, guys, all right. I get the joke, okay?
Now I've kind of gotten used to it. It's kind of annoying.
No, girl, you're not used to it. Okay, I am stopping the video here because I'm just sharing like an absurd story that I just don't want to relive. But this video, honestly, like with this being my first tag, I'm like, girl, you went in hard. You didn't have to go this hard, but you did. You bared your heart on your sleeve. Like, oh my God, you know? I really was not prepared for some of my answers in this video. Like I said, I uploaded this and then I literally never watched it again. And I just can't believe that this video exists. Like me just airing out all of my middle school drama and trauma to the internet. Whew, that was a lot, my darlings. Okay, we need to go on to a lighter note than the last video we just watched. So I'm going to transition into reacting to my first OOTD. I guess I had been shopping in Breckenridge with my sister. The post date on this was July 16th, 2011. And I guess we had gone on a family vacation and we're vibing. So this was the start of an era of making a lot of these. But let me just say, I already know that the Forever 21 is gonna step out in this, okay? Just before I press play, I just have to say the amount of bracelets I'm wearing and the cross necklace, Christian Girl Autumn is what I'm getting from this. With the cardigan, okay, I'm getting into it.
Hey guys, so I'm just gonna do a quick outfit of the day. And so first for my outfit, I'm wearing this purple cardigan that I got from Forever 21. And
I told you.
Loose fitting. Gray
tank top from my sister was coaching me.
High-waisted shorts that it's tucked into are from American Eagle. And then for my accessories, I'm wearing just keep going cross necklace that I got from.
She said just keep going.
Bracelets are just like
from various places.
Yeah, from a bunch of different places. Mm-hmm. And then for my earrings, I'm just wearing studs and other stuff. Mm-hmm. And then for my purse, I got this from a stand at the beach.
Wow, live for that bag. Wish I still had it.
It's just like these little slip-on shoes from Urban Outfitters.
Wow, miss their work.
And they have purple on them to match.
Cute. I'm turning around really quick.
It's like I was holding my sister hostage and forcing her to film me. She's like, okay, hey, keep going. Just keep going. Okay. And where is it from? They're from Aeropostale. Okay. Forever 21. Okay. Just say the bracelets are from various places. You could just fucking tell that Lindsay was so used to her formulaic OOTDs. And this was my first one. And she's like, this is how it's done, girl. Okay. I will coach you. Amazing. I just, again, have never watched that since I posted it. I can't believe it. That is a minute long video. Like, me now would never. Every video I upload is like at least 20 minutes long. It's ridiculous. The last video I'm going to be reacting to today is my first haul, because I still film hauls on this channel all the time. They're iconic content. And this haul is also from just an iconic era of YouTube, which was the back to school era. And when we were all in high school, all the OG beauty gurus, like August and leading up to August, you know, end of July, was just a huge moment for us. And not just even on YouTube, like you guys remember going to get your back to school supplies and your back to school outfits? It was a serve. It was. Historians will look back on this time and say that it was a serve. This video is also the second most viewed video on this channel. It had almost 20K, and all of the stores in this are Forever 21, American Eagle, H&M, JCPenney. All four of these, I would never ever shop at again because I stopped supporting fast fashion. But this just being like a symbol of the time is everything to me. And I just want to see some of the clothing pieces that I bought because I feel like my style was just so different back then. Let's get into it.
Hey guys, so today I'm going to be doing a haul from my back to school shopping. I'm gonna show you guys what I got. And so let's get started. So the first place we went to was—
so many jump cuts, I just have to say, in all these videos.
One clothes item there, but it was this dress.
Ooh.
It has spaghetti straps.
Love that for you.
It has this lace detailing.
I still talk about clothes the same way. I'm like, lace, detailing. Don't really know what it's called.
This little belt that goes over there, but I don't know how to work this. Okay, and this—
I don't know how to work this.
36 on the tag.
Oh my god, guys, I forgot about the era of YouTube where you would say how much everything costs. Like, we just completely stopped doing that after a few years, but you would hold up a piece and be like, I got this for X amount of money, or you would show the tag and be like, this was $15. And like, now I never do that. Also because most of my clothes are thrifted and I forget how expensive or inexpensive they were anyways, but I also just have to say the collage wall was coming along during this time.
With like discounts and everything. On my receipt it says it was—
I showed the receipts, sweeties.
So I got that. And then from JCPenney also, I've always really wanted— not like combat boots. Well, they are combat boots.
Not combat boots, but they are combat boots.
I don't know, but—
come on down, Rim.
And a lot of people think they're really weird, but I really like them. So does my sister. So I got them and I was so happy. So I don't think I'm really weird. But
don't think I'm really weird.
And they have kind of like a heel and then—
okay, why was I so scared about a combat boot? Was I scared that people would think I was like goth or something like that? I literally put at least a 30-second disclaimer before I showed the boot. The insecurity stepped out, the middle school anxiety stepped out here. But I just want to say that these combat boots were a staple in my wardrobe for at least like 6 years. So a truly iconic purchase.
And inside they're like plaid. I doubt you guys can see that.
We can see it.
Tie up and everything, and I just love them so much.
Okay, I kissed it.
It says I got those for $45.21.
Wow.
They were originally $70. That's pretty good. Okay, so that's all I got.
That is pretty good.
Penny, and then we went to Forever 25, $50. So why wouldn't I get that?
Okay. $5.50 for a skirt. This is what I'm saying with fast fashion prices. Like, are you kidding? For a new piece of clothing, I paid less than $6. Insane.
It's this rose colored— I don't even know. It's like, it's kind of like a tribal print.
I was thrown back upon seeing this garment. I stepped out on Facebook in this shirt.
Yeah, this is really cute. It was $17.80.
Wow, that's kind of expensive for Forever 21.
And then I got this other shirt. And
don't like that.
I don't even know how to describe this. It's just like tie-dye-ish. Not at all, actually. It's just
tie-dye. No, girl.
Short sleeve shirt. It has like a V.
Why? Okay, wait. Why is the only thing I'm purchasing and the only shirts I'm wearing, because I'm wearing one in this video as well, the baggy patterned shirt that I think I would always tuck into like a jean short or a pencil skirt? That was the vibe back then. It was baggy on the top, slim on the bottom. And this was another shirt for that. I think this is cheetah print.
And then in the back and on the sleeves.
No.
Up here, it's see-through in like this gray
color. Imagine me purchasing and wearing this
like
now.
Cheetah print or leopard print. And it has Marilyn Monroe.
This was the start of my Marilyn Monroe obsession via Tumblr. And obviously I think I purchased this at also Forever 21, but I wore this shirt so much I wore it into the ground. I would wear this to eighth grade parties with my pencil skirt and my combat boots. Your girl was serving. She was.
This other lace top, and it's navy blue.
No. I don't know why I did this face. Also why I didn't edit this part out. I just must have thought that it was very silly, but absolutely love this hot face for me.
And then I got this shirt and it's kind of an off-white color.
This shirt was also a staple of my Facebook. I would actually wear this now. I'm really struggling to describe this garment, but I remember her. Yeah. I need everyone to know that I wore this to meet Ellen Blair Fowler in 2011.
I got all shirts from there. Like, that is all shirts. Obviously, I need to get some pants or something.
Yes.
So, I got these,
It says, so my camera stopped filming here and I didn't notice until I had shown some other stuff and I guess I thought it recorded, but it didn't. So I just got these dark wash skinny jeans from Forever 21 for only $10.50. That was my last thing from Forever 21. Wow, $10.50 for jeans. They stepped out. Then we went to H&M, and in this next clip, you'll see me showing you guys the purse I got. It's blue leather with gold metal, and it's really big, and I love it.
And on the inside, it has like a bunch of pockets. And
I definitely
and
brought this to freshman year of high school.
Yes, but it's gonna hold so much stuff, and I'm so excited.
So much stuff.
And so I really love this bag. This was.
I put so much crap in here.
The place we went to was Claire's, and I had to go there to get a hoop earring for my cartilage. And so
yes. Wow. Throwback to an era where I would wear actually earrings other than just in my first hole. I think I had my second piercing, if not all of my cartilage. I have a triple pierce on this side and another one over here, and I literally never wear any of my cartilage piercings, and every time I put in earrings into them, I have to re-pierce the holes. But it's fine. It's fine. You know, maybe they've phased out for me. But also at the same time, I often get the urge to get more piercings. So it's like, why don't I just use the ones I have? Anyways, we're almost done with the haul.
So I got these. They're like a medium to dark.
The wash.
And I got them in short because I'm really short.
They were $27 with discounts and everything. They were originally $40. It was a steal, girls. She got a steal.
And they're stretched too, so that's good. If I need them to stretch, you know, get a little fat over the winter time. So
what? Get a little fat over the winter time. I was literally just talking in the Board in This Way tag about how you should never call people fat, and then I used the word. So this is exactly what people around this age do, is you are like, don't call people an idiot, it's an insult. And then you're like, ah, just hate when my friends are such idiots around me. It's just like so counterintuitive. Honestly, I apologize for 14-year-old me saying what I just did, because that was horrible. And I will be keeping it in. She needs to be exposed.
I have a pair of jeans from Delia's that do that. And I
Delia's,
that.
Oh my God.
So I got another.
My sister used to work at
so,
Delia's.
Yeah, that was my whole haul, and I know I got a lot of stuff, but it's for back to school. I go once a year.
The disclaimers. That was a lot for me. It was a lot, and I don't know how to feel about it. And in the bio, it says, P.S. I go back on the 15th for anyone wondering. For anybody who might be wondering what day I went back to school that year, I don't know how to feel about that video because there was just so much to unpack there. I was truly so awkward in my first videos. That's why I'm really happy I brought the Squishmallow today. My dogs are squeaking their toys behind me. Well, not dogs, plural, just Rue. It's always just Rue. But really, I needed the emotional support of Fantasia today. That was a lot for me. I was not expecting to see, you know, we started off with just some slight cringe with the music video. We quickly went into very serious middle school drama with my Born This Way tag. The OOTD was just absurd and very enlightening for Lindsay and I's relationship at the time. And the last video was me becoming slowly, metamorphosizing into Miss Meghan Makeup, which is truly, I guess, a great way to end off this video, because then I became this channel. You can go back and watch my earlier videos on this channel and cringe at those too. They're not all privated. I keep everything up on here, okay? You can see me from ages 15 to 24. This summer will be my 9-year anniversary on this channel, which is freaking crazy. But also, I feel like I've been on YouTube, you know, hence this channel existing, for at least like 10 or 11 years. So it's been a minute. And I appreciate any of you who used to watch these types of videos from me, because I'm pretty sure this was the first channel that Lindsay shouted out for me, so people would go and subscribe to Cheerleader for Life 647. Again, there's only one public video on this channel, but you can go watch it. It's Nevin and I's YOLO dancing video where we got kicked out of the mall for dancing in morph suits. Also an iconic video for that time. And thank you for joining me for the cringe today. Go check out the link in the description for a little discount on Surfshark VPN. Again, thank you for being here and witnessing this with me. If you didn't know, I stream on Twitch every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 6 p.m. Pacific time, so you can come hang the heck out. I also have a Patreon if you wanna see some extra content from me. And go ahead and give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and subscribe to my channel if you're not already. I love you guys so much. I'll talk to you very soon. Stay smiling. Bye, guys.